friends, welcome to my channel. My name is Anki. Thank you so much for watching this video. And today, as the title and thumbnail says, I am just doing a chatty, rambly, get ready with me talking about life stuff. So if that's not your cup of tea, I totally understand. But if you're nosy, then just keep on watching. I decided to pull out the Made by Mitchell Head in the Clouds palette. Is that your name? Yes, that's correct. This was a gift from my bestie and soul sister, Not Your Basic Steph, and this is what it looks like. I do like the color story, but all the shades are not my favorites. This was very hard to work with. This was hard. But I do love this shade and this shade. This shade is so beautiful. This was pretty beautiful as well. And that is what I used today. But yeah, I think I'm going to gift this to my niece, because the sparkly formula isn't my favorite, and yeah, I need more sparkle than that. So if you want to hear me ramble about my life for however long, then obviously keep on watching. Duh! I dry my eyes like I always do. If I forget any products, they will be linked or listed and or listed down below. Because this is going to be pretty rambly, probably. And my acne-filled face is here to stay, apparently. So for me, it's been almost 2 weeks since I filmed anything. It's been a lot. First off, my stepdad didn't see anything. My stepdad, which is more of a father to me than anyone else has ever been, got diagnosed with prostate cancer before Christmas. Which was a lot to handle. The urologist said that he was 99.9% sure that he would be able to remove everything and make him well again. So, but still, my anxiety went through the roof, and that's not the right brush. But he had a PET scan between Christmas and New Year's, and thankfully the cancer hadn't spread since when he was diagnosed with it, and it had not spread to the skeleton or anything, so that was amazing news. I feel going through this very fast today. So yeah, that was, of course, amazing news, and his surgery was set to the 21st of January, which, when I'm filming this, hasn't even happened yet. It's the 17th today, but this will go up the week after. But yeah, but he... way more muddy, and not in a good way than I thought it would. He told the doctor if there was a surgery date sooner, that he was interested in getting that. So he actually got the surgery on the 8th of January, 2 weeks earlier than first we thought at first. So he has been home recovering now for the past week and a half. When you're seeing this, almost 2 weeks. Is it 2 weeks? Yes, more than 2 weeks. So that is amazing. And he's doing well. I think the surgery went as the doctor foresaw. That was not a fun Christmas gift to get for any of us, but I'm so thankful that they discovered it as early as they did. Hopefully, the cancer will stay gone. But yeah, so that is one thing that has happened in my life. And again, trigger warning, mental health, crap like that. It hasn't necessarily been worse for me the past few weeks, but I am in full changing mood when it comes to my mental and physical health, because if you didn't know, my mental health is very, 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 very physical. So yeah, I'm focusing more on listening to my body instead of ignoring it. That I have been very good at doing that for the past, well, my entire life basically. So I am listening to my body when it says it needs to rest, if I have been sleeping badly the night before and I was going to film. I am not allowing myself to film. I'm not pushing myself to get it done. Well, that sounds bad. I always want to film, but I would push myself whether I want it or not because I wanted to film. But yeah, so I'm not doing that anymore, so I have no freaking idea how 2024 is going to be when it comes to my YouTube channel. Yeah, so I'm not pushing myself anymore, and I. Oh wow. I'm so blind, I can't see anything. I'm listening to my body because I am slowly and painfully realizing that if I ever want to get better, like, of course, I have gotten better than I was 5 years ago, but if I want to actually heal my body, both physically and mentally, I have to slow down. I have to do nothing when I don't have any energy, and I am sleeping so bad again lately because of the fucking ice cold, horrible weather, because that correlates to the electricity bill rising, and I don't have a lot of money for my electricity. So yeah, I have a better day today though. I didn't sleep amazing, but I slept a lot better and feel more myself today than I have for the past week, because I also had a panic attack during the night the first week of January, which I think, no, I haven't mentioned that because I filmed before that happened. So, I. Because the nervous system will not actually heal itself if I continue the way I have been doing, because it will just keep being in survival mode, and it has been in survival mode for like 33 years or something at this point. So it has really learned the negative mindset and goes in defense so quickly. So with me just pushing through that and just ignoring the pain and exhaustion and everything will just make my nervous system even worse, if that is even possible. So yeah, I have to bite the sour apple and accept, or at least acknowledge, I'm still not there. I still am not able to accept that my life is a fucking joke. It is so, it's not a joke, but it's such a sad life, and I don't want my life to continue to be as sad as it has been for the last 30 years. I want my future to be brighter, happier, better health-wise, and so I need to put in all the work. I can't just put in some work and not the rest, so here we are. And it fucking sucks. Even though I'm a little scared, because sometimes I actually enjoy sitting and doing nothing, and my anxiety gets so scared that that is how I'm going to be in the future, that I don't want to film YouTube videos, I don't want to play with makeup, etc., etc. I just want to sit on my ass and do nothing. But I've never been that person, so hopefully that is not the future I'm going to have. Hopefully the anxiety is not correct on that, but I feel the fear a little bit sometimes. But change is always scary for the most part, so I know what I have to do, and I just have to actually do it. Even though it's scary and stressful, and I get so much anxiety from sitting on my ass and doing nothing when I have a million billion ideas for makeup looks I want to create, and I can't because I need to rest. So it's an extremely hard cycle to break, but I've come so far. I'm such a different person now than I was 5 years ago before I started therapy, and I can't quit now. I can't be done. I just have to keep going and hoping that the future will be way more fun, more actually living and not just existing like I have been doing my whole life, practically. So, yeah. Here's to hoping. I'm still recording. So, yeah, that is the sucky throat. I can't speak. Well, that is the sucky truth. And yeah, I went off camera to figure out what color I want for my wing, what to put in my waterline, and my inner corner, and we'll be back, hopefully with my wing on. It's been so long again. Alright.
BRB.
Alright, the wing is on. Pretty good. Love the color. But yeah, that is what has have been going on in my life in the new year. Not a great start. Wasn't really surprised. It wasn't, but I was always hoping it would be better than 2023. Of course, we're only just starting in the new year, so there's always hope, but I was hoping it would start better for once. It always starts with me being too sick to film because of my mental health. So, but this year again was a conscious choice not to, because for the last 4 years I've hit my mental wall every single year between October and November. So I have had to recover either in November and December or in December and January. So I'm proud of myself for not hitting the wall, being more mindful of myself and my own boundaries and limits. So that is great, and that is something different from the other years, but it's still starting the same with me not being able to film and create everything that I want to. So yeah, but it is what it is. I can't do anything more about it than I already am. So yeah. Milo is doing well though. My cat, Milo, if you don't know who he is, he's my cat, and he's an anxious bean as well. So that is why I say he's doing as well as he can. Still going back and forth in my mind if I should actually start him on medication or not. But yeah. But he is loving the snow. Of course, he wish he could run in and out as he pleases like he does in the summer, but he is not paying the electrical bill, so he doesn't have any say in it. So I have to open the door and close it and open it for him like so many times throughout the day, because he will be out for maybe 15 minutes, then he wants to get inside again because it's cold, and then he wants out again. So yeah, but we'll insert a little video or videos of him. He is so adorable playing in the snow though. And he's getting so good with being outside with the door closed, because he wasn't able to do that in the beginning. So he has been like being able to stay out longer and longer without being scared and wanting to get inside again. But if there's a noise or anything that scares him, he wants to come in, obviously. But yeah, he's doing so well, and it makes me so happy, because then I can let him out and he can actually be out in his patio and get some fresh air without the door having to be open. So yeah. I'm going to have to go off camera to do the waterline, because I am using gel liners and it's a fucking nightmare having to make sure it doesn't transfer to my contacts before it dries down. So I will be back. I really don't know what else to talk about? I feel I have caught you guys up on what's been going on. And it's not really anything different from what's usually going on, but I have actually gotten a few new subscribers, so welcome if you're new, and of course welcome back if you are not new. So yeah, I am desperately waiting for spring before the electricity hell started. I loved the winter, I loved having snow, and I loved the colder it was, the more I loved it, but I can't afford to love winter anymore. That is that. So, spring. But I have a feeling we will have winter long into April, like we did last year. So, can't really do much about that. I just have to live in it. Look though, so cute. I just decided to do a chatty get ready with me because I honestly don't know how well it's going to go with the multiple looks videos. Those are my favorites, but I have therapy again next week for me, the week you're seeing this, so I don't know how that week is going to go either. I am bracing myself for the worst, but hoping for the best. So, alright, I'm going off camera to do my foundation at least, and then I will decide if I will come back and do blush, bronze. I don't use bronzer. I watch too many people that use bronzer. Contour, blush, and highlighter. I don't know if I'm all talked out or not. So I hate doing my foundation and stuff like that. And brows. And I definitely don't want to do that on camera. So, BRB. Alright. I am back. And clearly I have all my makeup on. Because I decided I was all talked out, so I decided to just finish my face while listening to music, so yeah. I know I haven't shown all the products, but I thought I would mention what I put on off camera, and I totally forgot to do that with the eyes. Oh damn. It's crashing down. So for my wing today, I went in with the Glossy Cosmetics Metallic Wet Liner in Lapis. It's so freaking gorgeous. For my waterline, I went in with two of the Lethal Cosmetics Side Effects Gel Liners. These are both collab with Teresa Is Dead, which is not available anymore, I think, but this is Spectre and this is Ectoplasm. This is my favorite of all favorites, and I don't have a freaking backup. Seriously. For my blush today, I went in with Coronation from Lethal Cosmetics from the Wildflower Collection, and I'm missing a nail, yes. I need to change my nails. They have grown out so much, so I didn't bother to put this on again, but this blush, I love her so much. And for my face highlighter and inner corner highlight, I'm using Parallax from Lethal Cosmetics, one of their iridescent single multichromes, and it is beyond gorgeous. And for my lips, I went in with the NYX Lingerie XXL. I have no idea what this name is. NYX Lingerie XXL liquid lipstick. It's black. And it's called Naughty Noir. It's pretty nice. This is the first time I'm trying it. It's not as dry as the purple I have, but it doesn't fade very nicely, but it's an okay black. It's the best black I have tried, except for Black Cat from Pretty Zombie Cosmetics. Also, my plugs are from A Love Kills Boutique. My earrings are from Macabre Cute Crafts on Etsy. My banana is from Sign with a Z. And my nails, minus one, is Franken Nails from Pretty Zombie. No, not Pretty Zombie Cosmetics. Perfectly Nailed, which sadly don't make press-on nails anymore. But yeah, that was everything. That was the entire video. It's been so long since I filmed a talking video, but we're at the end. The dark purple in this palette is so freaking annoying because it keeps disappearing, like it creeps up under my eyes instead of staying where I put it, but it is what it is. And I just got a message from my mom that my stepdad is... And I just got a message from my mom that my stepdad is going to have his checkup on Friday when I'm filming this. So the Friday before you're seeing this. So hopefully that goes well. And yeah. I'm tired, but energized at the same time. I don't know. I don't know. I just don't. Okay, friends, that's it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a huge thumbs up and maybe share it with your friends, because that helps me out so much. And please, just before you go, leave me a little comment. It helps me out so much as well. Let's talk about life. Let's talk about things. I don't know. I don't know. Let's chat. Let's talk about whatever you want to talk about. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, I would absolutely love to have you part of my online family. I do colorful looks like this. And I talk about colorful makeup because that's my style. And if you love color just as much as I do, or you want to get into color, I think you would enjoy my channel. If you're not already following me over on Instagram, I post every other day. And I would absolutely love to have you over there as well. It's just Makeup by Anki, like here. And it's always linked down in the description box. And until next time, I'll talk to you later. Bye!